Hello everyone, welcome to Salesforce Start. Okay, so in today's video we'll discuss about some more Salesforce Lightning interview questions. Okay, so in the last class we discussed some interview questions like this one, how to show or hide a Salesforce Lightning components, and we discussed about how to detect a Lightning component is using which browser, either iPhone or all those things. So already I have uploaded that videos in my YouTube channel. Can see here. So here we have a channel name is Salesforce Start. So here we have so many interview questions like admin, CPQ, okay, Chrome extensions, development, Lightning. So many interview questions are there. Even some mock interviews also there. You can just go through this channel so that it will help you to crack a interview easily. Okay. Hey guys, thanks. Then today, which question? What is the question they are asking in the nowadays? Nowadays they are asking this question in the interview. So this is maximum they're asking in all the interviews. So how we can pass data or value from parent to child component? So how many ways we can pass data from parent to child component? This is like a common question nowadays in all the interviews they're asking. Okay. So we can pass data from parent to child in many ways. So these are the like mainly we have three ways. Okay. So the easiest way is we can use the R attribute. Using attribute, we can pass data from child, parent to child. Okay. And other one is aura method. So we can create a method in a child component and we can call that method in the parent component and we can pass the parameters. Okay. This is the second way. And we can use the application event. So application event is like, we know already, right? This is like open source. So we can register event. We don't need for application events, not required to register event. We can call application event any component. There is no, we don't need any relationship like a child component, parent component. That is not required. Just we can call event any in any component. Okay. So these are the three ways we can go. We can pass data from one component to other component. So we'll go one by one in this video. First, we'll discuss about this one, and the next video I'll explain you aura method. In third video, I'll explain this application event. So this is like a mandatory interview question nowadays asking. Okay, so we'll go one by one now. So first we'll discuss about R attribute. So this is the easiest way to pass data from child to parent, sorry, parent to child. So I'll open my arc. Okay, so here I'll create one component, child component, Lightning component. I can give, for example, child component. Okay. 001, this is my child component. Okay, so if you want to use this component in any page, you can use this one. Okay, click submit. Okay, this is like my child component. So always best practice, we have to use we have to add some comments, okay, to the component. Just I'm giving component name here. You can add a component name when it is created and all those things. Okay, just I'm giving component name here to refer this component in other places. Okay, and I'll create one attribute here. For example, I can give one attribute or attribute. So I'll take attribute name equal to, for example, child message. Okay, I'll give attribute name equal to child message. Okay, and type is equal to string. Okay, so I have declared one attribute in the child component. Okay, for this attribute, I will pass data from the parent component. Okay, just I'll print data here. Whatever I'm passing data from parent to child, so I want to print that data here. I'll create one div. Okay, here I will print that information. So if you want to print, if you want to display attributes information, okay, in the component, we have to use a value provider v dot attribute name. Okay, so this is a child component. Just I'm printing that attribute here. So just I'll give some CSS. Okay, class equal to, so I'll give some border, I'll give some box, whatever you want. I'll give, for example, SLDS box. Okay, and if you want to give some margin also, you can give. I'll give margin. SLDS So margin, okay, I can give like around small. If you want to give margin like a small, medium, so whatever we can do, I will give small margin and I'll give some box. So this is a child component. So what I did, just I've created a child component. So I just have declared one attribute. That attribute I'm printing here in the box. So now I'll create one parent component. So from the parent component, I'll pass that to the child component. So this is the simplest way, easiest way we can pass data from parent to child component. I'll create a parent component 001. Okay. Just if you want to use any, if you want to use this component, any other pages, you can use these interfaces. Otherwise, you can ignore. Click on submit. So just I'm creating one more component here called parent component. Just I'll put a name here. Parent component. So 001. You can add more comments, created date, who is created by, what is the purpose, description, all those things you can add here in the comments. Now I'm taking only name of the component only. So what we have to do is, I'll create one more attribute here. For example, aura attribute. Okay, aura attribute. I'll declare one attribute and I'll give name equal to, for example, parent message. So why I'm giving child message, parent message? To understand easily, right? We can understand easily the naming conventions, how we can pass in data and all. For example, I give type is equal to string. Okay. I'll give some default value equals to, I am from parent component. Okay. So I have declared one attribute here called parent message. Now this attribute data I want to pass to the child component. How we can pass? So as we discussed, so first one is we can use the R attribute. We can call the child component in the parent. We can pass directly. So I'll call child component in the parent directly. How we can call? Just I'll give a component dot C namespace and child component. So here, I want to pass data to the which attribute? This attribute. So I can call this attribute here and just I can specify which data I want to watch. So I want to pass information from parent message, right? So I'll take this attribute here. So how we can pass V dot? If you want to pass data here, we have to use a value provider V dot parent message. Okay, so like this, we can pass data from parent component to child component. Okay. So if you want to test this application, if you want to test this component, what we can do? For example, I can give this a child component, right? I'll make it this component in a separate div here. Okay. So for the parent component, I can give some headers to identify easily. This is a parent component. Okay. So now if you want to test this these components, how we can test? Either we have to use this component in either the app builder or any other pages. Otherwise, I can create one lightning application. So there we can test this application. Parent. Otherwise, I can give demo app. Okay, so here we can call the parent component so that the parent component already we have declared child component. So both will display in the same parent component. Just click a preview. So this is a parent component. I am from parent component. There's no styles. If you want to apply styles, you can use extension equal to force colon SLES. Otherwise, lightning styles will not applicable. Okay. Click a save, just refresh the page. You can see. So this is a child component. I'm passing data from parent component. So whatever the default value is there, I am from parent component, that value I am assigning to the child component. So here we are using attribute name equal to child message attribute. For that, I am assigning a parent component value, parent attribute here. Like this is the one easiest way. So we can pass data from parent component to child component. Okay. So I think it is clear. I hope this will helps you. Okay. And in the next video, we'll discuss about how we can pass data from parent to child using RA method. Okay. Thanks, everyone. Have a good day.